there, Tommy. Guess you'll be surprised to get this letter from Vancouver. Well, I didn't go to camp after all. Finally convinced Mom and Dad that I just had to caddy at the Canadian Open. And boy, am I glad I did. Kid, you really missed something. It sure looked like Fletcher had everything sewed up. The gallery moved in to watch him play his second shot for the green. Pat was taking all the time in the world to make this one. Every shot counted. One mistake and Brideson might just find himself back in the running. The tension must have really been something, because just as he was about to hit the shot, he backed away from the ball, rubbed his right hand in the grass, looked to the green, took a practice swing, and started his address all over again. He played a beautiful two-iron shot right to the green. Could be another birdie. Remember, it's a par five hole. The crowd swarmed in, and as Pat walked up, the big gallery gave him a terrific hand. His first putt, from 25 feet, stopped a yard from the cup. Then Pat lined up his birdie putt. He looked at it from behind and at the side. He took a few practice strokes. Walked up to it. And sank it for a 72-hole total of 280. Four strokes under par, just about what the experts predicted on this tough course. The cheers and applause were terrific for the first Canadian in 40 years to win the Canadian Open. Yup, it was a pretty sure thing, as Bill Good said over the air. Unless the unlikely happened and Gordy Brideson shot the last three holes in five under par. He didn't. He parred the 16th, bogeyed the 17th, so he was now one over par in the championship. If he sank the next putt, it would give him a birdie and a total of 284. Even par for the 72 holes. He sank it, and as he walked off the green, the big crowd gave him a nice hand. And then he spotted Pat Fletcher and threw his arms around him. You could tell that as he wasn't able to win himself, he was pleased that Pat had. Then Pat and Gordy had to pose for pictures. Gee, it was a terrific win for Pat. The crowd kept applauding and congratulating him. And then, a little later, we were over at the first tee to see the presentation of prizes. Doug Bagis won a playoff with Bruce Cudd and received the amateur medal. Mr. McFarland presented a check for $1,350 to both Gordy Brideson and Bill Welch, since they tied for second place. Then Mr. Borland, president of the Royal Canadian Golf Association, presented Pat with the big money, a check for 3,000 smackers, and a miniature of the Seagram Gold Cup, which he keeps for good. Then Mr. Hamilton, the secretary of the RCGA, who was emceeing, announced that from one great champion to another, John Landy would present the Seagram Gold Cup to Pat. Imagine, John Landy, whose name will go down in history for running the fastest mile ever run.
Thank you very much. I'd just like to congratulate Pat Fletcher on a wonderful game of golf. I believe he's the first Canadian to win the Open Golf Championship since 1914, which is a wonderful achievement, and I'm sure every Canadian here is as happy as he is, and I was certainly very, very happy to see him do it.
I'd like to call Pat Fletcher now, the new Canadian Open champion from Saskatoon, and Pat will be awarded the Seagram Gold Cup. Here you are, Pat. I hope you can carry it all the way back to Saskatoon.
Hey, you better take this back, Mike.
Put it down there.
Pat, it's wonderful to have a Canadian as our new Open champion, and I'd like you to say a few words to the radio audience.
Well, of course, it's very, very nice to be the Canadian Open champion. I didn't think I'd ever see the day, but I can assure you I'm very, very happy. It's been a real thrill for me. I would also like to thank the gallery. They were really wonderful to play to, and I'd like to say thanks to everybody.
And Pat Fletcher will go down in history as the man who brought the Seagram Gold Cup back to Canada. Yeah, Tom, you really missed something.